Indian troops, in their fresh act of state terrorism, martyred a Kashmiri youth in the Kupwara district. The youth was killed during a cordon and search operation in the district. The operation was launched by the troops on the Tuesday night. Earlier, an Indian Army officer who sustained injuries in an attack in the same area succumbed to injuries at a hospital today. Indian police and dreaded agencies arrested a dozen people during the house raids in the Budgam and the Jammu areas of the territory on the charge of being involved in the pro-freedom activities. BJP regime dismissed four more Kashmiri employees, including two police constables. The employees were dismissed on the baseless charges, seen as a part of the broader agenda to replace the Kashmiri employees with the RSS BJP activists in the government departments to advance the Hindutva ideology in the territory. All parties Hurriyat Conference spokesman Advocate Abdul Rashid Minhas, in a statement in Srinagar, condemned the dismissal, saying that India has snatched every right from the Kashmiris, including the right to speech and the political activities. Jammu and Kashmir Democratic Freedom Party, in a statement, also criticized India's harassment of the Hurriyat leaders, termination of the Kashmiri employees and confiscation of the civilian properties in occupied Kashmir. The DFP called for the global intervention to resolve the Kashmir dispute and warned that further delay may lead to a nuclear conflict in the South Asia. Residents of the Baramulla district blocked the Srinagar-Baramulla highway for several hours over the apathy of the Indian authorities towards their daily needs. Congress party also took out a protest march in the Srinagar against a delegation of the dictatorial powers to the Lieutenant Governor by amending the Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act. The Congress leader Waqar Rasool Wani slammed the BJP government for failing to defuse the volatile situation and demanded that statehood restoration before the elections.